Hey folks, Dude Spin, how are y'all? We'll say finally able to go to the range to test fire the new Colt 1911. We had a few errors where it wouldn't slide lock. I don't know if that's normal, but I also shot my Glock 21, which I've owned for a longer time. Just to compare how it shoots with the Colt 1911. I've seen Colt 1911s versus Glock 21s before, and so I went ahead and did my own test to see which pistol is superior, and I put the results up here on Excel because I'm kind of a I am a numbers kind of guy, and as you can see, Colt 1911 versus Glock capacity goes to Glock, 13 versus 7 trigger. The Colt just feels better, even when dry firing. I don't know why why isn't there more pistols with this kind of trigger, because it's really, really good. The break, when the shot breaks, it's very crisp. Compared to the Glock, which is kind of sluggish, always been. Barrel length, we go to weight. That goes to the Glock, but in some circles, the weight of the Colt 1911 allows for better follow-up shots. I've experienced that myself. The weight of the Colt 1911 all steel feels better when you're shooting it. Barrel length, 5 inches to the Colt 1911 versus Glock, which is short of 5 inches. Years of service, this is a big one. From 1911 to present, some of our troops still use like variants of this, so that's gotta be a record for years of service right there. And accuracy, winner goes to the Colt 1911. My shot groups were kind of terrible today. I'm not very proud of the shot groups that I made with the Colt and the Glock. I have not shot the Glock in years. The Colt, this is the first time I'm shooting it. I only had 50 rounds because I wanted to like preserve my rounds for stockpiling purposes. I mean, ammo is still hard to come by, so I had to limit my session to like 50 rounds. Sighted in the Colt real quick, and with the Glock, just kind of came back to see where my bearings are, because I have not shot this gun in probably a few years, so I had to like relearn how to shoot it and aim it. And I forgot the basic tenets of pistol shooting, which is you're supposed to focus on the front sight. Maybe that's why my groups were all messed up. I'm not very proud of the groups that I put together, but here they are anyways for your viewing pleasure. 1911 on the left, Glock on the right. I had about 10 rounds left when I put these two targets up. So on the accuracy test, I put the Colt 1911 as the winner because, as you can see on the Colts, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, the fifth shot is somewhere, I don't know where it hit. And the Glock is more spread out, 1, 2, 3, 4, and I don't know where the fifth shot is. I'm thinking it might be that one. And so, as you can see, I did something right on these two, but these two are like to the side, and I'm very proud of that. And like I said, the Glock shot groups are just atrocious. This was at 7 yards, so clearly I need more practice, and I'll work on it. For my Colt 1911, so an upgrade that I did just tonight was I painted the front sight red, so it's a little bit easier to see. Hopefully that'll improve my shot groups a little bit better, but for my amateur shots, I put the winner as the Colt 1911. Some of you probably say, like, yeah, not very proud of my shots. Some of you are better shooters, clearly, but we're all trying to improve and get better. Anyways, no other faults on the Colt 1911. I mean, there were a few times the slide did not lock back, but I'm not sure if that's part of the break-in process, but anyways, I'm gonna try to do better on the next time around on the range. Anyways, here's the two participants, Colt 1911 and the Glock 21. Hope you have a good evening, and thank you for viewing my video. Thank you.